Hello and welcome to the 21st lecture of this lecture series introducing international investment law. In the last two lectures, we have been discussing the full protection and security standard or the FPSS in investment treaties. In this lecture, we will take up a very interesting topic. We will see how the standard was applied in the Louis Dreyfus Armatures SAS versus Republic of India arbitration, where India was successful in defending against claims relating to the breach of FPSS, expropriation, etc. For those interested, link to the award on the jurisdiction and the final award are provided in the description to this video. First, we will discuss how the arbitration in the LDA versus India matter arose. A port located in Kolkata, the port of Kolkata, decided to mechanize two berths at the Haldia port complex so as to enable mechanization of cargo handling, which was until then being undertaken through manual operations. LDA, or the Louis Dreyfus Armatures, held shares in a company called as Alba Asia Private Limited, or ALBA, which in turn held shares in another company called as Haldia Bulk Terminals Private Limited, or HBT. Alba was in fact a joint venture company consisting of ABG Port Trusts Limited, ABG Ports Limited, which held 51% of the shares, and LDA, which held 49%. Later, LDA's share increased to 50% and ABG Ports shareholding decreased to 50%. Now, in 2009, HBT, that is Haldia Bulk Terminals Private Limited, entered into an agreement with the Kolkata Port Trust for supply, operation and maintenance of different cargo handling equipment at the port. LDA primarily alleges that India's acts and omissions led to premature termination of the 2009 agreement. What are those actions? LDA alleged that India obstructed HBT from operationalizing the project. The police failed to ensure safe passage of HBT's cargo handling equipment to the berths. Kolkata Port coerced HBT to employ redundant workers and engage redundant subcontractors, which resulted in financial strain to HBT. When HBT retrenched extra workers, it was subjected to a violent backlash, including mobs preventing operations and assaulting HBT personnel and also threatening their personal security. For these actions, KOPT, that is Kolkata Port Trust, the police, the district magistrate and the Ministry of Shipping were allegedly unresponsive. It was also alleged that three HBT employees and their families were abducted at gunpoint. LDA also alleged that Kolkata Port choked HBT's finances by not allocating cargo. Finally, HBT was unable to withstand the continued financial and administrative pressure and was forced to terminate the agreement. Thus, these were various allegations that were made by LDA. Hence, LDA invoked the dispute resolution provisions under the India-France BIT of 1997. It complained of several breaches by India, including those of full protection and security standard. We are discussing the FPSS, and therefore we will look at how the tribunal determined whether the FPS standard was violated in this case. The FPS standard in Article 4, Subarticle 1 of the BIT read, "The investments made by investors of one contracting party shall enjoy full and complete protection and safety in the area of the other contracting party." On the standard in the BIT, the tribunal stated that LDA, in order to be successful, had to establish that LDA must show something more than a state failure to afford requisite protection and safety to HBT. Secondly, it must demonstrate either a failure to afford the required protection to ALBA itself or to LDA shareholding interest in ALBA, or a causal link between ALBA's ownership of HBT and state's conduct towards HBT, namely that state withheld protective services towards HBT on account of it being owned by ALBA, which in turn was owned at least partially by LDA. In other words, it must be demonstrated that the state intentionally targeted LDA's protected investment in ALBA by withholding protection to its constituent holding in HBT. In order to establish the violation of FPSS, LDA alleged, firstly, that India, through its police, district magistrate and CISF, that is Central Industrial Security Force, failed to secure HBT and its personnel from physical threats and harm, mainly because HBT's repeated requests and complaints over 2 years were ignored and the authorities did not prevent the abduction of personnel of HBT. Secondly, LDA also alleged that India violated the FPSS standard contained in Article 4, Subarticle 1 of the BAT when it failed to insulate HBT from Kolkata Ports and Ministry of Shipping's excesses and arbitrary and discriminatory behavior, including in allowing vested interests to interfere in the labor issues. According to LDA, these were violations of the FPSS in the BAT. The tribunal rejected the contentions of LDA and held the following. LDA was unable to show that the alleged inaction by state authorities was motivated by the identity of the upstream owners or by a desire to inflict harm on them. Secondly, although the tribunal did not discount the real threats faced by HBT and its personnel, it held that evidence did not support LDA's theory that the law enforcement authorities deliberately refrained from responding to the reported incidents. Thirdly, the tribunal stated that the limited effectiveness of the law enforcement response was more attributable to the size, mobility, and the reach of the protesting groups, and more precisely their tactics. The tribunal considered that such questions about proper deployment of law enforcement resources to be generally judgment calls to be made by a state acting in good faith to protect individuals and local businesses from intimidation and violence, and exercising the degree of due diligence required by international law based on the foreseeability of unrest in a particular area, the extent of available resources and competing demands for allocation of those resources among other areas potentially also in need of law enforcement protection. The tribunal held that tribunals should generally be wary of second-guessing these judgment calls except where evidence suggests bad faith, improper intent, or a serious lack of due diligence in response to a reasonably foreseeable and otherwise manageable threat. LDA admitted that Kolkata Port Trust was the first victim of the labor demonstration. Further evidence also pointed out that such labor protests were not unique to HBT alone. Based on these and other grounds, the tribunal dismissed LDA's claims in full. The salient portions of the final award are contained in Para 380 to Para 384 or 384. So readers who wish to have a quick look at the award may read these portions of the award. With this, we conclude our discussions on the FPSS. We will discuss another interesting substantive standard in the next lecture. Bye-bye and stay safe.